Behold! The greatest impersonator of the animal kingdom. This small cephalopod can be found in the shallow waters of the Indo-Pacific. Or maybe more accurately, it can't be found in the shallow waters of the Indo-Pacific. That's because it's often pretending to be something else entirely. This is the master of disguise, the mimic octopus. Hi, I'm Danielle Dufault, and you're watching Animalogic. The mimic octopus is an underwater changeling with the power to seemingly transform into other species at a moment's notice. At just 60 centimeters maximum, the mimic octopus, officially known as Thalmoctopus mimicus, is quite demure compared to its largest cousin, the giant Pacific octopus, which can reach up to 4 meters across. Most octopus species share the ability to change their color, shape, and texture in the blink of an eye. In the case of the mimic octopus, they take it a little further, doing a complete quick change faster than you can say, "I'll have the octopus ceviche." Camouflage in nature is used to help prey avoid being eaten. In some cases, camouflage is also used by predators to get close to prey without being detected. This adaptation is a serious evolutionary flex. Camouflage tactics usually involve blending in seamlessly with the background. But for a creature as talented as a mimic octopus, the point of changing its appearance isn't to blend in. It's to stand out and scream, "Come at me, I dare ya!" Researchers have reported seeing these octopuses transform into everything from mantis shrimp and giant crabs to seahorses and starfish. But their preferred disguise is that of creatures that are packed with dangerous venom. This intimidating facade ensures that any predators floating by are fooled into thinking this otherwise delicious octopus is something that's definitely not on the menu. Like many adaptations, the mimic octopus got so good at mimicking because of its chosen habitat, in the open sandy shallows near river mouths. These areas are teeming with predators like large bony fishes, sea snakes, and sharks. To stay hidden, most of the time they'll either be peeking out of their burrows or camouflaging motionlessly with their surroundings. But as soon as they have to move, their cover is blown. That's when it becomes very important to pretend you're someone else. The octopus, for example, puts on a venomous disguise, dressing itself up as a lionfish. After matching the lionfish's distinct stripes, the octopus mimics its venomous spines by holding its flattened tentacles up around its body.
Oh, hold on guys, I'm trying to catch a lionfish on Fishing Clash, the sponsor of this video, to show you how scary they are. This is one of the coolest ways of learning about fish without having to go to remote locations and seeing them in person. Wow, look at this thing. Beautiful model too, look at the texture on that. Fishing Clash has over 1,000 fish from all over the world. Different locations have different fish, and you level up to catch rare fish by getting better lures, rods, and power-ups. In Florida, lionfish are common fish, but as you get better gear, you get to see awesome fish like bonnethead sharks. You get to travel the world and see the local fish, from the Amazon to Hawaii, to even the Lost World, where you can catch extinct species. There's a lot of ways to play the game too. You can go on leisure fishing trips, do competitive online tournaments, and join your friends to start your very own clan. Check out the game by clicking the link in the description or scan the QR code here. And be sure to use the promo code Animalogic to get $20 worth of equipment and power-ups and a unique avatar. To redeem your special code, go to Settings, tap on Gift Codes, and enter Animalogic to unlock exclusive gifts from our channel. Follow the steps shown on the screen. Use that to collect all the fish and hopefully some mimic octopuses in disguise. And let me know which ones are your favorite fish. We might feature them on the show.
Not many creatures have the blind courage to swallow a spiny and venomous lionfish, so this disguise works quite nicely as a warning to would-be predators. Here, the octopus raises its crimped tentacles to mimic a sand anemone, which packs a toxic sting. In order to sell the deception, The mimic octopus does more than just transform its appearance. It even adopts its target species' movements and behaviors. Hey, it might not fool you, but it certainly fools its predators. When it transforms into a venomous jellyfish, for example, the mimic will wave its tentacles the same way a jelly does, as it propels itself upwards through the water. Here, we see a mimic octopus transforming into a banded sole before our very eyes. By holding its arms flush against its flattened body, the octopus can easily pass for this poisonous fish. When in sole mode, the octopus glides across the bottom, just like the fish, to fully sell its clever disguise. Here, an octodaddy takes the shape of one of the world's most venomous snakes, the banded sea crate, to ward off potential predators. It achieves this threatening look by pulling six of its tentacles out of sight and stretching out the remaining two in opposite directions. It then, of course, dons the striking black and light gray stripes that are the hallmark of this highly venomous snake. Here is a mimic octo pretending to be a moray eel, a fish that packs a powerful bite and whose colors resemble those of venomous snakes. So this octo may actually be mimicking a non-venomous eel who itself is mimicking a venomous snake. Things can get very meta on the seafloor. If mimic octopuses weren't shapeshifty enough, they are often mistaken for their closely related but smaller cousin, Wonderpus photogenicus, otherwise known as the Wonderpus octopus. Admittedly, they do look quite similar, but there are a few small differences, most notably the long eye stalks of the Wonderpus, which give it an adorably cartoonish look. Both the Wonderpus and the mimic have Oscar-worthy acting abilities, but even though the Wonderpus has more charisma, the mimic seems to have more range, at least for what researchers have observed in the wild. Octopuses can color change thanks to specialized cells called chromatophores, located just below the surface of their skin. The center of each chromatophore cell contains a sac of pigment in colors like black, brown, orange, or yellow. To change color, each sac stretches or shrinks to give the right hue. Not only can octopuses change color, they can also change texture. Projections on the skin, called papillae, adjust to create textures ranging from smooth to bumpy. A true testament to their ability to hide in plain sight is the fact that mimic octopuses weren't even discovered until 1998. Our very limited experience with these incredible mimics means that we're just at the beginning of our understanding of what they can do. Right now, we don't even know for certain the extent of the mimicking capabilities of these octopuses. Scientists believe that we've only seen a fraction of the disguises these mimics can do. Who knows? Maybe your favorite YouTube show is run by mimic octopuses pretending to be nature documentary filmmakers. So what should we talk about next? Please let me know in the comments, and don't forget to subscribe for new episodes every week. Thank you so much for watching, and see ya! Don't forget to download Fishing Clash by clicking the link in the description.